in America. Barbed wire in Hungary. There's a lot of talking about borders lately. Scary borders, actually. But today I want to talk about a totally different kind of border. Yes, even a border that shows the beautiful side of it. A lot of times I take the train from Berlin to Amsterdam. And then you cross this one gray border station, Bad Bentheim. I don't know if you know it. It's the border station between Germany and the Netherlands. It's not beautiful, it's not exciting at all. Just the changing of the personnel in the locomotive, and you have to stop there for 10 minutes. But when this happens, the mood in the train also changes. So recently, I again took this train, and for 4 hours, I had this extremely serious looking, not so really happy German conductor, I must admit. And after Bad Bentheim, suddenly this loud Dutch voice sounded through the intercom. He made a bit of a blunt joke about his colleague. And yes, he wanted to show us what a relaxed, normal guy he was. So typically Dutch, actually. And he laughed himself the most about it. These are clichés. On the one hand, we have this blunt Dutchman. On the other, there's the serious German. And you can have a lot of examples that show the opposite. But still, at this border station, they sometimes become awkwardly true. And for me, it's even a reason to take this train sometimes. I don't know how it is with you, but I love these culture shocks, especially at seemingly useless border stations. They inspire me even for my work as a journalist. They not only show me the view of the Dutch towards the Germans to the Dutch, but more importantly, over the years, they've learned me the best state of mind to cross this border with. Already 25 years ago, it's a long time when I think about it, I was the first time at this Bad Bentheim. It was a different Germany, the country of Helmut Kohl, right after the reunification, and my family had avoided Germany for decades because of the war. I was pretty excited. I was heading to Berlin, full of expectations, and then I had my first encounter with a German conductor. There was a minor problem with my train ticket, but he made this huge problem of it. And I remember it still, because for me, this guy was so brusque, so bureaucratic, and I became angry. But afterwards, my reaction also fitted in a kind of general opinion we Dutch had about the Germans. The sick man of Europe, Germany was later called, economically troubled, the culture lacking modernity, and of course, I must admit, we thought that every German secretly was still a Nazi. We, on the other hand, we the Dutch, we were the cool country. We thought ourselves the moral guiding nation in Europe. Tolerant, dynamic, multicultural. The better Germans, we were even called by a German magazine. So yes, I was glad to be back again at Bad Bentheim and hear this loud jokes of the Dutch conductor. But still, 17 years later, 2009, I stood there again, ready to live in Germany, to establish myself as a correspondent in the Germany of Angela Merkel. It was a different Germany, I must admit, but moreover, I really wanted to leave the Netherlands. I couldn't take a Dutch joke anymore. I even enjoyed now this German conductor who seemed suddenly the best example of industriousness and punctuality. And I longed, of course, for Berlin, where everything would be better than in Amsterdam. And again, I fitted in a kind of general trend. And it went even further than I could imagine. It was the opposite of everything which happened 15 years before. In 2013, I was a guest at an event about the German elections in Amsterdam. It was organized by a young, hip advertisement agency, and we all got funny cups with I Love Germany on it. And you could see famous Dutch intellectuals walking around, telling in the TV cameras that they had always loved the Germans. And now, the conservative ones, they praised the German economy, the revived economy, which made the country the strongest nation in Europe. But moreover, the liberal ones, they put Germany forward as a new role model on moral issues. And this was totally new. They especially praised the correct tone in the debates on migration, and at the same time, criticizing their own country, the Netherlands, for the opposite. Because now the Netherlands were the troubled country. In the Dutch and German media, we had now this reputation of anti-migrant, even xenophobic. So now the Germans play the role of the better Dutchman. Of course, reality isn't that black and white. And where else than at Bad Bentheim I realized this? Around the same time, I got there again after this long tour now, with even 2 hours longer. There was a delay on the German side, so much for this German punctuality. And there he stood already, the Dutch conductor. And he was a typically Dutch cliché, he was singing. But on the other hand, he was exactly the opposite of this new reputation of this anti-migrant Netherlands, because he had this Suriname background. And I was intrigued by him. But why? Because in the Netherlands, this was perfectly normal already for decades. But I had lived the last years in Germany, and there, until recently, it was a bit unusual. So, you had the harsh debates in the Netherlands, but on the other hand, the country was much more mixed, the society. And in Germany, you had the correct talking, but society still has to open itself. And this is important to stress here, because it shows that reality on this other side of the border may seem better or may seem worse, but it's just mostly much more complex. And it also shows that it's not only facts that determine how we judge this other country, but our projections, how we look at it. Let me zoom into this a bit. So in the 90s, Germany was seen as the bad neighbor in the Netherlands because we, the Netherlands, had this moral superiority. And after 2001, this changed radically because the self-image of the Dutch changed also. There was an unprecedented self-criticism after two political killings, economic instability, and of course, the rise of right-wing populism. So now the Dutch couldn't be this moral guiding nation anymore, and even this Dutch brusqueness, which was only years before seen as honest and direct, seemed only a few steps away from a new rudeness in the political arena. So Germany now got this other positive role. And in Germany, this projection functioned the other way around. So in the 90s, there was a lot of self-criticism, and the Dutch could play this role of better Germans. But the last years, Germany really likes to show itself to the world as the beacon of stability and moral enlightenment, gladly pointing at others who aren't that illuminated. And for me as a journalist especially, it's very important, even crucial, to be aware of these kinds of mechanisms. Projections are more powerful than facts. So if you want to know what's going on the other side of the border, you not only should cross it, but also cross this mental border. So, how the future will look like? I was in the train a few months ago, Bad Bentheim, and a major police force came in, even with dogs and weapons. It's the result of the call for stronger borders, new nationalism, and terrorist threats. Maybe this is a new phase in Europe, and this will influence how the Dutch and the Germans will deal with each other. I already hear the Dutch intellectuals brag that they have so much more experience with these kinds of turbulence than the naive Germans. And others say, well, Germany can be the new leader of the free world. Well, I, after 8 years of professional border crossing, I landed somewhere in the middle. And maybe this sounds a bit indecisive to you, but it's really practical. And I think also important to stress in these times where there's on the one hand this new nationalism and on the other hand a kind of superficial globalism. So now, because I cannot choose this one country over the other anymore, because I now realize that I benefit from their cultural differences. And this also works on a non-personal level. So these two countries now experience more than in the last 25 years the same problems. And yes, they have different approaches to solve them, but this is also an advantage. To take this example of the two clichés I mentioned before, sometimes it would be really healthy for Germany to have a bit more Dutch bluntness. And sometimes the Netherlands could use a bit more German correctness. So a border is mostly seen as the end of something, the end of something you know. But the border is also the beginning of something new, the beginning of something you might want to know. And exactly that's why I'm glad there is still this Bad Bentheim, this gray border station, where you have to stop for 10 minutes just enjoying these nice culture shocks and realize this one good thing about the border. Thank you.